The US president has been under fierce attack this week after his decision to deploy the National Guard to deal with protesters after some of them became violent. But according to an exclusive poll carried out by the Democracy Institute in America, President Trump is still 1 point ahead of his Democrat rival, the former Vice President Joe Biden, by 48% to 47%, with 5% undecided. Crucially though, Mr. Trump is 6 points ahead in the swing states of Florida, Iowa, Michigan, Minnesota, Pennsylvania and Wisconsin by 50% to 44%. Based on these results, the president would see off his rival in the Electoral College by 293 votes to 245, with Trump picking up Minnesota, where George Floyd was killed, in the Democrat stronghold of New Hampshire, but losing Michigan and Wisconsin. In a week where he has faced intense scrutiny and criticism, the shock poll suggests that voters in the U.S. approve of the way he has handled the crisis by 56% to 40%. In a week where violent protests have damaged many people's businesses, property and lives, Trump's decision to call Antifa protest group terrorists got a 56% approval rating, while the same number think Biden has not been strong enough in condemning violence. Given a choice, 63% want law and order prioritized, while only 32% want relations with Black Americans and the police prioritized. And with Democrat administrations in U.S. states and cities threatening to defund the police, 73% said they were opposed to the move. A White House source told the Sunday Express that public criticism of the president had been unfair and he wanted to see justice for George Floyd. The source said, "There is no one who supported the policeman's actions. No one. There is no one defending it. So the protesters have no one to be against. Peaceful protest is always welcome. The looting and devastation is not, by any community. But I'm not sure who they are protesting against, since no one is on the other side of this argument." However, the president does not score well on his handling of coronavirus, with 44% disapproval to 40% approval after he pushed for a quick ending of lockdown measures. However, 60% said he was not indirectly responsible for 100,000 coronavirus deaths in America. The projected election victory comes despite a negative rating on how well he is leading the country, with 49% approving to 51% disapproving. The racial split in his support shows that 59% of white voters back him, but surprisingly he also has the support of 40% of Black voters, which is historically high for a Republican candidate. The president is also more attractive to older voters, with 51% of 65-plus-year-olds and 57% of 45- to 64-year-olds, but only 40% of 18- to 29-year-olds. Trump's voters are more loyal, with 74% describing themselves as strong supporters, while only 49% of Biden's potential voters describe themselves as strong supporters, and 65% admit he is a negative vote to stop Trump. However, only 37% of Trump voters would want their friends and family to know how they had voted, while 74% of Biden's supporters are comfortable with it being known, suggesting there is a silent vote for the president, while 71% describe Trump as a strong leader and 70% a populist. 59% think Biden is the best consensus leader and 57% say he is the establishment politician. But while 62% say Biden is the more likable politician and would be better to have a beer with, 53% think he is too old. Notably, 27% would not want either politician to babysit their children. Democracy Institute poll: should government prioritize law and order on city streets or prioritize improving relations between Black Americans and the police? Law and order equals 63%. Improving relations between Black Americans and police equals 32%. Do you support D, funding your local police department? Yes equals 14%. No equals 73%. Will Trump or Biden do a better job of standing up to China? Trump equals 59%. Biden equals 37%. Will there be a significant economic recovery this year? Yes equals 62%. No equals 38%. Don't know equals 13%. Poll methodology: the fieldwork for this survey of a randomly selected national telephone, landline and cell sample of 1,500 likely voters was conducted by the Democracy Institute's polling units from June 3 to June 5, 2020. The survey was conducted via interactive voice response, in which recorded questions were played for randomly dialed respondents and answers were given via their telephone keypads. The poll has a margin of error of 2.5% at a 95% confidence interval. To ensure a representative sample, the results were weighted for key demographic and political variables, including, but not limited to, party identification, gender, age, education, income, region, voting history, and cell phone-only households. The party identification turnout model is Democrats equals 38%, Republicans equals 38%, and Independents equals 24%.